can we make sure that we have wanted to make sure we get the standards right, we have the standard process. And one of the first things on the board was to let the operator know that we're shut down. So if we're following that process, now we got to work on the next process and making sure that they understand that needs to remove boxes. We just have excess boxes, but they need to remove when we're pulling the mold out, okay? Green Toys is going to be here tomorrow at 10 o'clock, so please, they're going to be here for a couple hours, make sure everything's clean and ready to go. We had an improvement for the gear ratchet. It's cool. As you can see, we just, it was, again, an improvement. It was put into a blue bit, so we knew where everything was. And then it was actually put in Kaizen foam with labels, so now it's even easier to find what you're looking for. And actually has a cutout to grab the wrench out of there, so you can use your hand to grab it. So Nick did a nice job. Let's give Nick a big hand. So, nice job, man. Good job. All right. We're talking about communication at Toyota. And they were talking, the last one we talked is Mike House recalls. I remember one of my first managers, Tom Hall, town hall meeting, in which a green, newly promoted 28-year-old manager stood in front of a couple hundred team members fielding touchy questions and concerns. One of the members raising a concern could be best described as a rough guy. He was an older man and quite honestly intimidated me. He voiced a somewhat personal concern about his process equipment and not wanting to take time away from others more general and common concerns. I asked him to wait until the end of the meeting and we would discuss it then. I could tell he took it as a brush off and didn't expect me to follow up with him. In fact, he didn't even wait around at the end and started to head out to the plant. I caught up with him and got a surprised look when I asked him to show me what his concern on the plant floor. He enthusiastically took me to the process and explained the issue and his frustration with no apparent countermeasures being taken. I got the group leader there and was able to get the right support people there, on site, to work on the equipment, incorporating the members' ideas. In the middle of the interaction, he turned to me with a serious look and said, "You really give a darn, don't you?" It was one of the best compliments I could get, and from that day forward, I had a friend on the line I could smile at, wave to, and touch base with. Alright? That's obviously Mr. Shiko talked about the same story in China when he started up a plant, just getting that one person making sure he's there concern and support, again, and showing the support for the production and the facility, okay? This is a video piece Paul Akers is doing for a company that's doing their annual meeting that he talks about passion for lean and everything else. So we're going to talk with them in the next couple of days.